on Gwangju, day two of the 28th Summer University Games here in Korea. In tonight's highlights, Chile takes on Korea in women's volleyball. We have diving, men's synchronized 3-meter springboard, as well as women's platform. There are four gold medal judo boats that we'll take a look at here this evening. Busy night at the pool, with six gold medals being handed out in the sprints and long distance. We'll also move to shooting, women's trap and men's 10-meter air rifle. And we'll have two gold medal contests on the piste at fencing. Pool A competition in women's volleyball. This one featured Korea and Chile from the Yeomju Gymnasium here in Gwangju. Korea lost their opening match 3-1 to China, while Chile lost their opening match 3-1 to Colombia. We'll jump here to the third set. Chile up 2-0. A rather long rally here between these two teams. There from Sotomayor, dug up by Korea. And then the relatively easy block by Lozano and Sotomayor to win that point. Now 5-3 Chile, Sotomayor to serve, and that one will drop just in front of the Korean libero, Kim. 6-3 now, Chile in front. Korea serving. This over to Sayo. That one goes high off the block of Chile, and the Chileans cannot corral it. Korea back even at six. Later in the set, Chile up now 19-14. Back there from Sayo. Set up again for Sayo. That one though off the block of Lozano and Steinmetz. Chile up by six. Now to match point, Korea serving. Back there on a great dig, but it goes a little bit long in the easy tip over from Isadora Steinmetz. And Chile will win this one. 3-0 over the Koreans to equal their record at 1-1. Korea will fall to 0-2 now in Pool A. From the Nambu University Aquatic Center, it is diving competition. First up, we'll take a look at the men's synchronized 3-meter springboard. There you see the dive order in this final. Take a look now at Jenny Novoselov and Vyacheslav Novoselov. This will be a forward 3.5 somersault. Very well executed dive.
Nine.
By those brothers.
Nine and a half. Nine. Torres
very
score.
Clean entry and good synchronization. They'll score 81.84.
Mexico. Up.
Now jump back to the fourth dive for the Chinese pair of Li Yanan and Zhang Yuming. This is a forward 2.5 somersault with two twists. Off on the synchronization there, as you can
execution.
See. Get a
seven
better close-up look at
eight.
It here.
Seven and a half.
They will receive a score of 80.58. Now the Korean duo of Kim Jin Yong and Song Tae Lang. This is an inward 2.5 somersault dive for the pair. Really clean entry for the two. We'll see what they score in terms of synchronization. And in the end, it will be the Russian pair, the Novoselovs. They will take the gold medal. Jenny won gold in the springboard in 09 in Belgrade and bronze in Kazan. So he adds to that total.
관중 여러분께서는 선수의 경기에 방해가
Take a look now at Wang Ying. This is a back 2.5 somersault with 1.5 twists. China took silver and bronze in this event back in Kazan in 2013. Dive there for Wang.
Eight, 7.5. Total score, 75.2.
All the effort there to gain that entry. A bit of splash on the entry. She'll get a score of 75.20. Now to the fourth dive for Wang Han, also of China. Reverse 2.5 somersault dive. Rip entry there for Wang. That should put her in a good position nearing the end of this final competition.
Taneka Kovchenko, Hosu,
76.50 for her. Next up, Mai Nakagawa of Japan. She competed in the 2008 and 2012 Summer Olympics.
Seven, forward, three and a half somersault dive.
You'll see in slow motion those three and a half somersaults.
72.0.
And a bit of splash on entry, a score of 72 for her. Wang Ying, though, takes gold. Wang Han will take silver. And Nakagawa of Japan, she will win the bronze medal. Selena Toth of Canada narrowly misses bronze in fourth position. Swimming action continues on day two here in Guangzhou at the Nambu University Aquatic Center. We'll get going with the men's 800-meter freestyle final. This features Sergei Frolov of Ukraine, won the silver medal in this event in Kazan back in 2013. He also won a 1,500-meter bronze. Bronze medal. And there you see Frolov now with four Universiade medals to his credit. Now to the sprint, men's 50-meter butterfly final.
Ladies and gentlemen,
lane assignments. Susan Martins of Brazil. He's now posted by Alan Kirkman of Belarus and Carol Podia of Italy. It'll be a very close finish here. Kirkman tied for gold at Universiade in Kazan. But this time it'll be D'Souza Martins. He will take the gold medal just ahead of Kirkman. Carol Podia, who won bronze in this event in Kazan. Does the same
the medal awarding ceremony will begin shortly.
There you see the three medalists. Now the men's 100-meter backstroke final. Yesterday as part of the men's 4x100-meter freestyle relay. It's a very close finish. Asagawa just in front there in lane four, and he will touch first, just ahead of Christopher Cicciolese of Italy. Conger picks up his second medal of these games. Jacob Pebley of the United States, who's bronze this in Kazan.
감사합니다.
He just finishes off the podium. Moving now to the women's 200-meter backstroke. There's the lane assignments. And as we move here towards the finish, with Lisa Bratton comfortably in front, she will take gold in a time of 2 minutes, 9.31 seconds. Simona Bamutova of the Czech Republic will take silver. Well, Yuka Kawayoke of Japan wins bronze.
감사합니다. Ladies and gentlemen, this
Now the breaststroke, men's 100 meters. Dimitri Ballenden in lane 5. He won the breaststroke triple at last year's 2013 Asian Games in the 15 meter, 100 meter, and 200 meter. He's very close between Ballenden and Jay Wilby of Great Britain. Ballenden will keep off the two Brits. He will win the time of 59.96 seconds. Wilby will take the silver.
관중여부는 이상으로 시상식을 마치겠습니다. 감사합니다.
He will win bronze.
Please welcome the athletes for the final women's 50-meter butterfly.
A flurry of splash and spray. Looking to do it again. And she has pulled in front. She will take the gold medal here. Svetlana Timurova of Russia takes silver. Holly Barrett, who was fifth in this event in Kazan, she
감사합니다.
Moves up to take bronze here in Gwangju. Women's judo action on day two from the Yeomju Bitgul Gymnasium here in Gwangju. Look for under 63 kilogram class. This is the gold medal bout between Megumi Tagani of Japan and Bak Byun of Korea. Bak Byun White won a silver at the Asian Games in 2014. Tagani and Liu won the European Open event earlier this year in February. And there is the epon for Tagani. And that will give her the gold medal. You see a good replay, great technique there by Tsugane. Flame goal. There you see the medalists, Kaczynski and Wickers receiving bronze medals. Now moving to the men's under 81 kilogram class, Hassan Kalmirzaev of Russia taking on Wang Kichun of Korea. Wang in white. Very decorated judoka, two-time Universiade gold medalist from Kazan in 2013 and Belgrade in 2009. Silver medalist from the 2008 Olympic Games in Beijing and a two-time World Championship gold medalist from 2007 and 2009. Right here, the Pools of Wang has scored a Raza Ali with time ticking down. Then you'll see the score actually change and rewarded instead a Yuko. Raza Ari, scored earlier by Kalmirzaev, will hold up. You can see the confusion on the face of Wang as he thought he was about to win gold, but instead it'll be the Russian who will win the gold medal in the men's under 81 kilo class. Kohara and Alardon will win bronze medals. Back now to the under 70 kilogram class. Suzuki Osanai of Japan and Kim Seong-yeon of Korea. Kim in white, gold medalist of the Asian Games, and a silver in those games in the team competition. Osanai won bronze at the European Open event earlier this year in Bulgaria. And a great move there by Kim. They scored two Yukos. And you'll see the time ticking down. And the Korean favorite will win gold on home soil. Silver. Hino of France will take bronze, as will Kashkin of Kazakhstan. And there you see the four medalists. Finally, the men's under 90 kilo class. Ruk Dong-han of Korea taking on Kuzan Kalmirzaev, his brother earlier winning gold. Ruk in blue, Kalmirzaev in white. And there, he will score the epon. Ruk, with that, will take the gold medal. Kalmirzaev is not one of his brother's footsteps in gold himself. He will take silver. And here you get a slow motion replay of the epon that won Ruk the gold medal. Nagasawa and Assis will win bronze to round out the men's under 90 kilogram class. From the Naju Jilinamdo shooting range here in Gwangju, more shooting action here on day two. First up, the men's 10-meter air rifle competition. This features the defending gold medalist from Kazan, Liu Zhiguo of China. He already defended his team gold medal earlier today that he'd won back in Kazan.
Behind the first place.
There you see Park Sung-hyun of Korea. He won a silver earlier today to add to his bronze from Kazan. That silver was won in the team competition. And there you see Liu of China.
And the fifth place.
It also features Yang Haoran of China. He's the world top-ranked competitor in the 10-meter air rifle right now and was the gold medal winner earlier today in the team along with Liu. You get another look at Park. Here is Yang, as mentioned, the world number one right now in this event. But on this day, it will be Liu, who equals a finals Universiad record with a score of 207.5 to win the gold medal. Now moving on to the women's trap gold medal match. This features two Italians, Silvana Stanco and Federica Caposuzio. Stanco won gold at a World Cup event this year in the United Arab Emirates and was 18th at last year's World Championships in Granada, Spain. Caposuzio was 6th at the 2013 World Championships in Peru and was 11th at that same United Arab Emirates event earlier this year. And to get here, they had to defeat two medalists from the Kazan Universiad. Catherine Skinner of Australia won gold, and Svetlana Krashenkova won silver, but they both could not get to the final. There you see Stanco on the left, Caposuzio on the right, there she is. Missed that target. That one is hit by Stanco, and that would be enough. Stanco will win the gold medal, hitting 11 targets to the 9 from Caposuzio. Catherine Skinner of Australia, the gold medalist in Kazan, she wins bronze here in Korea. We go back to the Kim Dae-jung Convention Center for women's individual foil in fencing competition here at Universiad. Jeremine Empanyanga taking on Svetlana Tripopina. And there you see the French woman on the left and Tripopina of Russia on the right. 3-1 right now in favor of Empanyanga. In foil, the target area is the torso. The head, arms, and legs are off limits. Empanyanga beat Hong Hyo-jin in the semifinal 15-12, while Tripopina knocked off countrywoman Kristina Novolinska 15-8. A great battle there as Empanyanga gets the point. She's now up 11-7. And a nice attack there from Tripopina to get a little bit closer. But she can't build on that momentum as Empanyanga moves up 13-11. Tripopina trying to stay in it, now 13-12. Empanyanga scores there. And now 14-12. Empanyanga can't quite win it, Tripopina gets close, down one, but there it is, the final attack. And Jeremine Empanyanga wins the gold medal, 15-13 over Svetlana Tripopina of Russia. congratulated there by her coach. Hong Hyo Jin of Korea wins bronze, as does Kristina Novolinska of Russia. And there you see the four medalists in women's individual foil. Now on to the men's individual épée final. This features two Frenchmen, Yannick Borel and Virgil Marchal. In épée, the target area is the whole body. Borel is a past team world champion and European champion from back in 2011. He lost in the quarterfinal at the London 2012 Summer Olympics. There are points scored by Marchal. Down by one. There's a great quick attack from Borel. He's now up 8-5. Another quick strike there from Borel, proving to be a challenge for Marchal. Marchal beat Jung Tae-sung of Korea to get to this goal.